What's up, guys? Void here, coming back at you all with yet another spoiler video for Rivals of Ixalan. Looks like we have four spoiled cards here. The one card is very important, we'll get to that last, but three of which I'm going to try to speed up here. These are more or less just some limited cards, just your basic commons, uncommons. First one we have is River Darter, a 3-mana blue 2/3 merfolk warrior. It cannot be blocked by dinosaurs, so at best, this is limited playable. However, I don't really feel like these do too well. It is just a 2/3 for 3 mana. Not going to see much play. It doesn't have flying or anything like that. Any sort of good keywords. So it's very specific. You have to hope that limited is going to be an environment filled with dinosaurs, which if it's anything like Ixalan limited, it probably will, but doesn't look too good. The next one we have is Threshing Brontodon, a 3-mana, 3/4 green dinosaur. Has an activated ability of pay 1 to sacrifice it, destroy target artifact or enchantment. As far as limited goes, this is pretty solid. A 3/4 for 3, likely also going to be a popular color in limited. Green has a lot of good dinosaurs, you have a lot of good value, especially if you go back to Ixalan, you had some decent ones there. And also, the fact that he has the ability to get rid of artifacts or enchantments is very underrated in limited. But again, a lot of these cards here I don't see going past limited into commander or even standard. The next one is Atsakan Seer, 3-mana in Celestia colors, for a 2/3 human druid that can tap to add 1 mana of any color to your mana pool. So a 3-mana mana dork, we're never really going to be seeing any of these 1-mana mana dorks like your Elvish Mystics, Llanowar Elves. Those are a thing of the past, so we have to get used to seeing things like these, which isn't terrible. I've seen a lot of good limited decks that use 3-mana mana dorks, and they work out pretty well. Also has an activated ability, sacrifice Atsakan Seer, return target dinosaur card from your graveyard to your hand, so very specific towards dinosaurs, but I could definitely see this being playable and limited. Maybe even standard, but even then that might be a stretch. But most importantly, we see Angrath the Flame Chained, the newest Planeswalker. We saw the Planeswalker deck version of him that wasn't too great. The 5-mana version here in Rakdos colors for a 4 loyalty Planeswalker that's pretty solid. It has a +1 of each opponent discards a card and then loses 2 life. That's pretty good. That's not terrible on a +1. Usually +1s have a habit of being cantrips or something of that nature. This one is just pure hate on your opponents. The -3, gain control of target creature until end of turn, untap it against haste until end of turn, and then you sacrifice it at the beginning of the next end step if it has a converted mana cost of 3 or less. So it's Slave of Bolas if Slave of Bolas worked for creatures on CMC 3 or less, which the biggest upside to that card is that you have to sacrifice it at the end step. You don't give it back to your opponent. So already, as far as limited goes, this is pretty good, but I already made a pretty decent commander deck out of Karavak the Merciless, and I feel like this Planeswalker would fit in pretty well in that deck. So just some food for thought as far as commander goes, and his alt is a -8. Each opponent loses life equal to the number of cards in his or her graveyard. Well, this has commander written all over it. A lot of graveyards can be massive in commander. So as far as alts go, not really bad. As far as a Planeswalker for commander, my channel is primarily known as a commander channel, so whenever I look at Planeswalkers, I automatically see if there's any playability in the format. And this guy is actually pretty decent. He's not overwhelming. He's not the Rakdos Planeswalker that's going to just fit into every single Rakdos deck ever. But as I mentioned before, if you want to go with something like Karavak the Merciless, something a little bit more spiteful, I feel like he fits in a little bit better as far as that deck goes. But overall, pretty interesting. Not upset about the spoilers at all. I think it's very interesting. We're probably going to be getting some more throughout this week as spoiler season is starting for Rivals of Ixalan. So anyway, guys, let me know what you think about these four cards. Let me know what you think about Angrath especially. Brand new Planeswalker, brand new character. I think he's pretty cool. So anyway, you guys have a wonderful new year. Have a wonderful day. Void here signing off.